All right, everyone, I've got some great news, which I think many of you will absolutely love, whether you are already trying this feature or not with your Seestar. ZWO, the makers of the Seestar, are currently working on an equatorial mode. That's right, an official equatorial mode that will be a part of your Seestar app. So it sounds like it's going to be an app update in the very near future. Now, as of the date of this video, from what they're saying is this will be sometime before April, which means February, March. And this is pretty exciting. And stay with me here because I want to show you where you'll be able to find this option in your Seestar app once the update is pushed to us or given to us. And in the meantime, while I talk about this, as you can see, I'm imaging Jupiter in the background. I have it under stargazing mode, but it's looking really good. I should switch over to planetary mode so we can see Jupiter better, but this is really nice because I have a full moon right now and you can see the four moons of Jupiter, which is really, really cool. So I'll switch it up in a bit, hopefully before the end of the video. But what I want to mention about this exciting news is that this is something that a lot of us have been waiting for. Now, when it comes to equatorial mode, we know that a lot of people are already doing their own equatorial mode setup with their Seestars, with their Seestar S50 or even the new Seestar S30, which is totally fine. And they've been able to work around with this through other means, other platforms, or with other ways that other developers have done to be able to use this mode. And it's worked out well from what I hear from them. But a lot of people now, they want something that perhaps is not as complicated or just a little bit more user-friendly. And we can trust that the makers of the Seestar will for sure provide an app that's intuitive, easy to use. And let me go ahead and show you guys where this update will be pushed to. So let me turn over my screen here. So the new equatorial mode, and stay with me because I'm going to explain a bit more into this. If we go under the advanced features, that's exactly where we're going to find it. Not now, but when it comes out. So you see the advanced features here, and it's going to be right under your initialization and calibration. And from what I looked up, it'll be called EQ mount mode. So it'll be right under your advanced features. Let me show that again. So we click on here, we click under advanced features, and it's gonna be right here, which will open up for you to have the option to use equatorial mode or not, which is just absolutely going to be a game changer. And the reason being is that right now, when we use the Seestar without equatorial mode, here I am trying to look at Jupiter, but we don't have the clearest skies. It's not good, but that's okay. Now, if you're wondering what exactly equatorial mode is and what this is going to do, if you notice right now, for those of us that are not using any type of setup of equatorial mode, when you're taking images right now with your Seestar for a long time, you're going to notice that in the corners you get some artifacts there, or you might have to crop your image at the end because it doesn't look that good around the corners. And this is caused by field rotation, which is due to the type of mount that we are currently using on the Seestar. That is that our mount right now only moves up and down and left and right. So an EQ mount is slightly different and removes that field rotation, allowing you to image the target for longer without having so many stacks failed, basically less discarded images, because now your images will look clearer and the mount is going to note that field rotation that happens, right? So it's going to move in this direction instead of the direction that we have it now. Now, all of this information regarding this update is coming from a representative of the Seestar who recently posted a video about it, and I'll put a link in the description to this. And not only that, but ZWO Seestar, the official social media account, has recently posted some images. So here it is from the official Seestar Instagram. These are some of the images that they are doing. These are test samples of equatorial mode and how our images are going to look. Let's check these out. If you notice, this looks absolutely amazing. And I am assuming these must be Bortle 1 skies. On top of that, these images have probably already been AI denoised, if you know what I'm talking about. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I just recently made a video about that. So it will make your images clearer. And I'll post a link to that as well. But look at how incredible this looks. And as you can tell, there's like no issues here in the corners. These actually just look absolutely crisp. Now, from what ZWO is also saying is that they will probably provide their own wedge or their own accessory to purchase for the Seestar, some type of mount. We shall see, but that would be really cool. But for those of you who don't want to wait for that, you can actually get your own mount now, if you'd like to be ready, and I will have links in the description of that as well. One of them is the Skywatcher mount, which a lot of people are already using and have been using successfully for their Seestar. Now, let me know in the comments what you're thinking about this update. Are you ready for it? Have you been waiting? Let me know what you think. By the way, I don't want to forget something that I want to mention from what ZWO has mentioned regarding these images is that these testing samples, it says here that they each image was around 1 hour. 1 hour with 30-second subframes. So that's incredible. You know, right now, we are mainly using the 10-second feature, right? And it's because it'll just have less discarded frames. That's the whole reason why we need equatorial mode. So if we can start doing 30-second exposures, it's going to be absolutely incredible. I have something important I need to say. One of the most exciting things about using the Seestar is sharing our images and results with others. But sometimes we can't go to all the star parties or gather all our friends to come and image with us. But I have good news for you, something exciting. Astro Room just opened a Discord server just for you. Your own portal to the cosmos, not just on YouTube, but on Discord now. While you're there, you can live stream your Seestar to others. Screencast your Seestar imaging in real time to multiple people at once. Or simply join the live streams just to watch. Come see what others just like you are imaging right now. You can also chat and discuss all things Seestar and tips and tricks with the Astro Room community. You can even share your astro images with me and more. Joining the Discord server is free. I'll put links below in the description. Now, I have a very special free trial for Sky live streaming for all of you to join as a thank you for all of your support. Please check out Sky live stream in the Discord server. Screencast your Seestar imaging and share it with others in real time as you also watch others live stream theirs. Let's join the Astro Room Discord community and build it up together. Come hang out and chat, and I'll see you there. By the way, as a side note, I just want to point out that I'm hearing that a lot of you are still having problems finding the moon in the Seestar, where it's just, in particular with the S50, where it's just not ever grabbing your moon when you're trying to locate it. Now, I've done a lot of tips and tricks regarding this, but I'm going to give a really quick tip right now, which is mostly what will work over 90% of the time will be for you to find two star first. Make sure your Seestar, of course, first of all, make sure that it's leveled. Second of all, what you want to do is find two stars, one on the east, one on the west. And that way you will let your Seestar know where exactly you are. So of course it knows your location, it knows everything, but this makes it easier for it to find the moon a lot more quickly. So it doesn't have to be exactly one all the way to the east, one all the way to the west, but the more further apart, the better. Perhaps maybe just one all the way to the east, one maybe a little bit north, but two stars far apart from each other. Get them both in your stargazing. Once you know they're both there and they're both centered in your stargazing and your Seestar found them, then you want to go to find moon with your Seestar, and which is what I just did now. That should pull it up for you fairly quickly. If it doesn't work the first, second time, try it again. but that should work for you.